There are two ways that you can use this first text tool. The first one was just the basic text. If you remember, if you just choose this text tool here, click once anywhere and type, and then get the black arrow, and this will allow you to resize any text. Now, if you choose the text tool but don't just click once, what you do this time is just hold the mouse down and drag and then just let go. And now, just to save time, I'm going to paste some text in, but it's just the same as typing it, so I'm just going to paste some text in here. And what we've done here is we've created a box or a column to allow the text to go into it. Now, the difference between these two methods is this. If I get the black arrow and try to resize it, it won't resize the text, it just resizes the column. If I squash this up here like that, you can see the text has to fit into there. And if I do it that way, the text just fits in. By the way, this little red thing here means that there's overflow. In other words, my box isn't really big enough for the amount of text that I have. I'll just move this out of the way and see if I can show you. If I pull this right down, there you can see now the little red symbols disappeared. Now we can see all the text. I'll just put it back into a column like that for a moment and show you how we can now create another column by just simply clicking on there and then just click anywhere. We now have two columns of text that are linked together. In other words, if I move this one up like that, the text that was in there will flow into the other one, and so on. Again, this is showing us here that we've got some text still to come. So if I make the whole thing bigger, you can see the little arrow showing that they are linked there. If I make each column bigger here, and then make this one a bit bigger as well, I'll just move it up there, we should be able to see all our text, and there it is. So that's two linking columns. The difference here is to do with resizing the text, because obviously we can't use these handles to resize the text. So in this case, the only way that we can resize the text is to simply select it, go to type and size. This is the only way we can do it when it's in a column like this. So that's quite an interesting way of creating columns of text if you need to.